Yeah, yeah, ooh, yeah, yeah. It's the singer's eyes, the singer's only. Singer's eyes, the singer's only.
Hey, you guys, it's Kristal Cherelle from Indie Artist School. Welcome to the Singer's Arsenal. So this is another episode of the Inspired By series, and today I wanted to talk about why I'm inspired by Jazmine Sullivan. So I'm not even going to lie, you know, I was a little late to the game. I remember the first song I ever heard by Jazmine Sullivan was Circles, but I do feel like she has definitely underrated because her voice is amazing. She's got power, she's got character, and she's got vocal runs for days. Her agility is through the roof, and I feel like more people should be talking about it, but anyway, that's why I'm going to be reacting to one of her live performances of her singing Forever Don't Last. It's from 2015 in Birmingham, Alabama, and I just really loved this, this song, and there's something that just gets captured in a live performance that's just very different than the studio. I know that a lot of R&B and soul singers tend to ad lib a lot more live just because you're feeling it. And so you're going to be a little bit more adventurous. And it's kind of like catching lightning in a bottle sometimes. Like, they might not ever do that again, you know, for that song. You don't know, but I just like to think that they're being a bit more spontaneous. And so I wanted to do a reaction video on her performance. So here we go.
I had high hopes for us, baby. Like I was on dope for us, baby. Chasing after high that I never get back again.
She came out the gate running. See how she switched to her
and it became painfully clear
her head voice, yeah.
We will never see those days again.
So remember when we were talking about in the last episode, I was talking about what your superpower is. So Jazmine Sullivan, while she does have a dark timbre and raspiness to her voice, she is a mezzo-soprano. So her mixed register is really the sweet spot for her. And you can hear how she started off pretty low in her chest voice. It sounded good because she has that dark timbre. So it was really cool and rich. But as she started going up into her head voice, you heard how easy it was for her to shift into that because she has a really strong mixed register. It was very easy for her to move through there. And we can hear that rasp and all of that character in her voice a lot more clearly here. But yeah, I just had to go ahead and say, yes, ma'am. All right, let's keep going.
But I guess forever doesn't last too long forever.
Hear that mix.
Too long these days, hey. And I tried to believe that we could make it, but trying don't work, so I just had to face that forever doesn't last too long these days. Hey. Still think about the good times we had.
Did y'all hear that? Still think about. So she went from her chest, the good, and then she came up into her mix. Did you hear that? You could hear that shift a little bit harder. So it sounds like she has an easier time going from her mix to her head voice. But that chest to mix still sounded very good. All right. And I think she also did that for character too. That's a style choice. All right, here we go.
And how you used to make me laugh. But baby, I know.
There it is. There we go. Yes.
So every time I wanna call,
mm-hmm.
Baby, what always helps is when I think of the pain and I realize I'm better off by myself. 'Cause forever doesn't last too long. Forever.
You heard that, Ryan? So something that she likes to do a lot is a pentatonic minor run. That was so beautiful, effortless. Okay, so after double checking on the piano, it became very clear to me that it's actually not a C sharp minor pentatonic. I made that mistake because I heard the C sharp beginning the run, but really it was the last four notes of an A major pentatonic scale. And the way I ruled that out was because I heard the A at the end of her scale. When she had that at the end of her run, I knew, wait a minute, that's not a minor pentatonic. So really, instead of going, which would be a whole A major pentatonic scale, she just did the last four notes. Hopefully that clears things up.
Does it last too long these days? Hey.
Ooh.
And I try to believe that we can make it.
Those are the special moments I miss right now. Come on, background. There we go. Do y'all hear how fast those notes are? Oh my goodness. Especially, first of all, a lot of artists have a struggle between only singing descending runs all the time. One thing I really love about Jazmine is she will sing runs going up and down and without thinking twice about it. And I love how fast the speed of those notes at the end are. Like, that is very hard to do. But yes, ma'am, let's keep going. And her pitch is so spot on. These are very clean. And if you're listening on the podcast and you don't see this, I'm just going to tell you right now, she's sitting down, guys. She's not even standing for this. And a lot of people would say, like, you know, singing while you're sitting is harder. But one thing I will say, and this is something I teach all of my students who are learning how to belt, sometimes it's a little bit easier for you to feel your pelvic floor pushing downwards as you're sitting. So as you're projecting from your diaphragm and belting outwards, you're going to feel that pressure, and it's going to feel like it's going down towards the chair and out forward as well, instead of, you know, hunching your chest over and like collapsing your chest and everything. And you could see that, you know, her posture is still pretty much upright throughout the whole performance, even though she's sitting. She leans a little bit, you know, as she's getting into the song. But that's one thing I will say, when you are trained and you've got your posture and you understand how to belt, sitting down is not going to take away your power. Because if you know how to sit upright and make sure you're still projecting and breathing in from your diaphragm, then you got it. Okay, so let's keep listening. She's killing it right now. Hold up. Let's just talk about what just happened at the end of that riff right there. So she just shifted between her chest voice into her falsetto, and she did it quickly. So she had a lot of pressure build up in that chest voice. It was very powerful, full, a lot of projection from her diaphragm, and she had a little bit more of a closed chord closure, which gave that little bit of grit in the lower end. And then she immediately released all the pressure and allowed a lot more air through, which gave her that airy high note, which is that true falsetto. It's not as closed as her head voice would have been. She didn't do that. She went You hear the difference? Yeah, and she killed it. So that's just another testament to how much control she has over her voice. So one thing I will say, like it might sound, if you're listening, that she was straining a little bit. But one thing I want to say is that Jazmine has grit. So she has a natural rasp to her voice. If you ever hear her talking or singing, it's just in there. She's not doing anything artificially to manipulate her voice to get that rasp in there. So yes, she is allowing some pressure to build up as she's approaching those higher notes. But that is a stylistic choice for her. It's not something she's doing because she's actually straining. It's just like she's allowing some pressure to build up to give you that feeling of urgency and like I really mean this. So you can use those things to your advantage when you're skilled and you know what you're doing. Okay, so I just want to go ahead and address that right now. So yeah, because she's not straining in the video, but yeah. I'm gonna fast forward a little bit because I think this is a musical break. Yes, ma'am. You see how she ended on that in the mix? I love it because she went. One thing I really love about that ending right there is she went down to her chest voice, right? And it was very rich that time. I felt like it was my favorite of her chest voice that I've heard so far in this performance. And then she made sure that you heard that most resonant mixed belt that she's got with that grit in there, her signature, right? So I just wanted to go over that today. I love me some Jazmine Sullivan, like, yes. So if you want to learn how to develop your voice and learn how to sing vocal runs better, learn how to belt, understand how to find your voice, go ahead and visit my website, indie-artist.teachable.com. That's indie-artist.teachable.com. And while you're on the site, don't forget to click that subscribe button so that I can send you vocal tips directly to your email inbox. Also, please don't forget to support this podcast. I really enjoy creating this content for you guys and giving vocal tips and advice for you guys, but it does take time and resources that I'm paying for, so your help would be amazing. So you can help by going to anchor.fm/thesingersarsenal/support. That's anchor.fm/thesingersarsenal/support. And I just gotta say, for those of you who have already donated and are already supporting, thank you so much for all of your help. Well, you guys, until next time, have a wonderful day.
Yeah, 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 ye